Game Show Network. All play, all day.
You can win this sporty red Jeep on the turn of a single card on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks.
Well, thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. Nice to have you with us today. You see this smile on my face? The smile on my face is because Tyler Ann Eubanks was born the other night. I'm a grandfather for the very first time. How about that, Jed? Huh? I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying. Oh, he's much too young to be a grandfather. And you're right, but it's the truth. We have a new car to give away. We have two nice contestants and two beautiful dealers. Why don't we meet them right now? Here they are. Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams are dealers on Card Sharks. Here they are.
You can call me Grandpa.
Okay.
Or you can call me Granddad.
I will.
Or you can call me Boss. But you can deal the cards, okay? Let's get our card sharks. Come on, gang. Come in here. Yeah. Julie is our champion, by the way. Welcome back, Julie.
Thank you.
Nice to have you here. You got $400 so far. And tell us about Julie.
My name is Julie Reed. I've lived in L.A. for 4 years, and I like to swim and dance.
At the same time?
If possible.
I understand. Okay. Nice to have you back with us. Katie, hello.
Hi, I'm Katie Broy. I used to be in vaudeville years ago.
What'd you do?
I was a part of a song and dance team. I tap, acrobatic, and belly danced.
No kidding. I wish we had time.
I'm glad you don't.
Okay. I got the belly, I can tell you that. All right, we're going to pick it up from where we left off last time. If you remember, we were in the middle of our second game. Julie had won the first game, and Susanna's got the cards dealt out, and we are ready to ask the first question in game number two. That's where we are right now. If Julie wins the game, she's the champ again. Katie, you have to win this game in order to stay in the match. So good luck to the two of you, and here we go with our first question. It goes to you, Katie. Remember, this is game number two now. Question number one. Surveyed 100 married men. We ask them, do you tell your wife you love her because you really feel like saying it, or because that's what she wants to hear? Now, how many married men said they tell their wife they love her because that's what she wants to hear?
Oh, gee, that is true. Wives and girlfriends like to hear, I love you, a lot.
So do guys.
Oh, yeah. Well, and my husband tells me that every night at 5 o'clock. I know.
Let me ask you a question. What happens after 5 o'clock?
The truth. I can be cooking or doing anything else, and he says, I love you, and I love to hear it.
He's rather predictable, isn't he?
Yes, but he tells me in the morning, too. But I know at 5 o'clock before the news comes on, he's going to say, I love you, honey. And that's great. So I think 60%.
60 out of 100, you're saying. Not percent, but 60 out of 100 say they tell their wives they love them
60,
just because it's
right.
What they want to hear. All right, Julie, higher or lower than 60?
Well, I think Katie's on the nose there that men tell them because they like to, but they also tell him a lot because their wives want to hear it. I know my boyfriend, I nudge him and say, don't you love me? And then he'll tell me. So,
I like a secure woman. That's great.
I'm so secure. Please tell me. So I think it's going to be a little, I don't think that many men tell their wives.
So you're telling me what, higher or lower?
A little lower.
A little lower. Actual number of married men who tell their wife they love her because that's what she wants to hear is 16 of them. You're right. It was a lot lower. See there? Yeah. I know. All right. Julie has the control. There we go, Julie. There's the card. How about
that? Lower.
We're going lower. You bet we are.
I'm going to freeze.
You going to freeze? All right. She'll freeze there. It keeps her opponent away from the cards. We will pause for these words, and we'll be right back to find out who our champion's going to be. It'll be Julie or Katie. Let you know in just a moment. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Now, let's continue with this game, and the next question goes to you, Julie. And let me tell you, folks, all this week, we're going to have 10 deputies from the San Bernardino County Sheriff's Department with us, and here they are right now. I want you to meet them. Ladies, welcome. Well, I tell you what, if I'm going to be arrested, that's where I want to be arrested. Right down there. Okay, Julie, before the show, we asked these 10 officers, has a man you arrested ever asked you for a date? How many of these 10 officers said a man they arrested has asked them for a date?
Well, they're all very pretty ladies, and I'm That's sure these right. men want to get out of their tickets as fast as
get
they can.
Get out of their
can.
What, honey?
Out of getting tickets.
Oh, their tickets. Oh.
Not their shorts. And I don't know, men out there are pretty gutsy, so I'm going to say that at least six of them.
Six out of the ten of these officers said a man they arrested has asked them for a date. Katie, will be higher or lower than six?
I think it'll be lower because I think men are intimidated by a...
woman with a gun.
Yeah, that helps.
Sheriff or not.
Yeah, I'm sure it's lower.
You think it's lower than that? Actual number of these officers who said a man they arrested has asked them for a date is four of them. You're right, Katie, it wasn't lower. I can't even imagine it. Boy, that takes a lot of guts. Which four of you ladies have had this happen to you? Raise your hand if you would, please. Melanie, what happened?
Well, I arrested a guy for assault with a deadly weapon.
You can put your hand down, Melanie. Unless you want to put them both up, and then you're under arrest. Okay, you arrested a guy with assault with a deadly weapon.
Right, and I put him back in my patrol car. He was kind of a dirtbag individual.
Yes. Man of classy nature, yes.
And as I was getting ready to take him to jail, he asked me for a date. And I turned around and I told him, I like my men to have all their teeth.
That did it, didn't it? All right, ladies, thank you. It's going to be fun, I can tell. Nice to have you. Woo! Yeah. I like those law terms. Kind of a sleaze bag kind of a guy. Yeah. Who is it, Katie? All right, Katie, look at here. I got a five. You can change if you want to, hon.
Higher.
Higher going on. Keep the five. No.
Oh.
No. Julie, that means you get a free chance at this thing with a seven.
Higher.
Higher than a seven, it is.
Lower.
Lower than a jack, it is.
Freeze.
Freeze there. Yes. All right, works her way across the board. One card away from the championship is where she is. Katie, you got to do some catching up.
I sure do.
And I've got a question to give you that chance. Here we go. We surveyed 100 mothers of 10 children or more.
Where's me? I'll think.
We asked them, since you woke up this morning, have you had to wait for someone in your family to get out of the bathroom before you could get in? How many of those moms said they did have to wait for someone to get out of the bathroom before they could get in?
Oh. Of 10 children.
Yes.
Well, it depends, of course, how many bathrooms they have in the house, but not many places have 10 bathrooms. And you're always waiting for it. I would say that a mother wouldn't stay in bed until they get out of the bathroom.
Well,
they have to do
that.
A lot of work.
I didn't ask that. Have you had to wait for someone in your family
yes,
to get out of the bathroom
yes.
before you could get in?
I know I used to have to wait for my kids, and I only had two of them. So
I only had three. I used to go outside.
Oh, I would.
So you live in the country, you know?
I would say that, all right, I'll say 58 of them.
58 out of 100 moms said they did have to wait for someone to get out of the bathroom before they could get in.
Yeah.
Julie, higher or lower than 58?
I'm one of four girls, Bob, and my poor father waited all the time, and we had two bathrooms. So I'm going to say it's going to be higher than 58.
I think it might be higher than that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Roseanne Barr, the comedian, says the best birth control in the world is to spend an hour with your kids before you go to bed. The actual number of moms who had to wait for someone to get out of the bathroom before they could get in is 41. No, it wasn't higher, it was lower, and Katie has the control. Katie, you want to keep the five, hon?
Change that
five. Change the five. That was bad to you last time, wasn't it? Let's see what the five is. Five's now deuce. How's that?
Higher.
Gotta go higher. Here we go.
Higher.
Higher again. Is it higher? Yes, it is.
Freeze.
Yeah. Made me nervous on the other card. Okay, so that means that Julie doesn't get to the cards. We're going to play Sudden Death in just a moment. We'll be right back with that. Don't go away now. Okay, now, this is Sudden Death. Fourth and final question. Someone has to win the game on the next play of the cards. If it's Julie, she's the champ. We'll go on to play for the big money. If it's Katie, we'll play a tiebreaker game. So good luck to the two of you. Here we go. Sudden Death. Julie, the question's yours. It's an educated guess question. According to Fortune magazine, how many of the 50 biggest companies in the world are American?
Ooh, I don't have much knowledge on that, but I know that a lot of foreign trade's coming in, so I'm going to say out of the 50, only 27.
Katie, will it be higher or lower than 27?
She's right. We do have a lot of new people coming in and taking over big companies, but I think it's still a little higher.
Even higher than that, all right? The actual number of the world's 50 largest companies that are American is 21.
Oh.
Wasn't higher. It was a little bit lower. All right. Now, sudden death is what we're playing.
Take
Julie.
That card.
Wait a minute. Just a second. You got some options, my dear, okay? Because it is sudden death. You can change the card and play it out. If you goof, she wins the game, or you can pass it on to Katie. She must play off the eight. If she goofs, you win the game and the match.
I'm gonna change that card.
You're gonna change the card and do it yourself. All right, let's see what the seven becomes now. The seven is now a four.
Higher.
If it's higher, you are the champ again. No. Oh, that means that Katie wins the game. We play tiebreaker. Woo! Wow. Katie was out the door.
Clearly.
She was collecting her nice prizes and saying, boy, that was fun. Okay, that means we've got one game for each one of our contestants. I think you did it right, though. One game for each contestant. We're going to play a tiebreaker game. In the tiebreaker game, if you know, Susanna will deal out only three cards, and we have a maximum of three high-low questions. So the winner of this game truly is the champ. Good luck. Here we go. Katie, first question's yours. Surveyed 100 senior citizen women who are newlyweds. Oh, we did find 100 of those little devils, didn't we? And we asked them, is this your first marriage? How many newlywed senior women said this is their first marriage?
Not very many. I'm a senior, needless to say, and this is my second marriage. I've only been married 10 years to this gentleman, and I knew a lot of people that were single, but they were only single because of death in the family, a husband. And so I would think that I would think that by 100, I would say 75.
75 out of 100 newlywed senior citizen women said this is their first marriage. Is that what you're telling me?
Mm-hmm. No, 75, no, 25.
Oh,
first
25
marriage.
Then. Okay,
yes,
I want to make sure the answer matches. All right, let's see what Julie says about this. Higher or lower, Julie?
Ooh, that's. I think she's pretty close, but I think it's going to be a little. Just a little bit higher.
A little bit higher.
Just
all right.
Tad.
Well, the actual number of newlywed senior citizen women who said this is their first marriage is 17. Not higher, it was lower. Katie,
oh, can't believe it.
Katie, three cards away. Here we go, dear. Let's see.
Oh, lower.
Lower. No. Katie was counting championship money that time. Don't get mad at it. It's just a card. It's only a game, Susanna. Julie, free chance.
All right, lower.
Lower than the jack. Yeah.
Higher. This time it better.
All right,
be
the four
higher,
bit you last time. See if it does this time. If it's higher, you're the champ. Play for the big money in a new car. Higher than the four. Now you guys are getting mad.
I can't believe it.
Gee, I'm the only one up here who's not angry.
I'm not angry.
All right, here we go again. Next question is yours, Julie, and this question involves our 10 deputies from the San Bernardino County Sheriff's Department. One of them who likes their men to have all their teeth. Julie, before the show, we asked these 10 officers, have you ever had to subdue a man who was much bigger than you? How many of these 10 officers have had to subdue a man who was much bigger?
Wow. I'd say probably several of them, because they're not huge women, and the men are, men seem always bigger. So,
especially bad men.
Bad men always.
Bad men are big.
I'm going to say at least five of them.
Five of them.
Five.
Let's see what your competitor says, Katie.
Well, I'll say higher than that.
I think it might be higher. The actual number of these officers who've had to subdue a man who was much bigger is 8 of them. Yeah, was higher. Which 8 of you ladies have had to do this? Raise your hand if you would, please. Gail, what happened?
Actually, it was my first physical confrontation with a male. I didn't know how I was going to react.
I'm sorry, hon.
And I was trying to take him to jail, and he didn't want to go, so he hauled off and hit me, and I just turned around, and I hit him as hard as I could, and he went down. And I think I was more surprised than he was.
I can imagine. Okay, thank you, ladies, very much. All right. That's a tough lady. Katie, gonna go lower than the king? Let's see.
Oh. Higher!
If it's higher, you're the new
higher.
Champ. Higher! Higher. What'd you say?
Higher!
Higher! Yeah. Julie, we leave you with $400. Thank you so very much for being
with us. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Come on, Katie.
Katie's our new champion. Boy, that was tough. You were gone, you were back again, gone and back again. But now you're back. And now we're going to play for big money and a new Jeep, and you'd look spiffy in that Jeep, I'll tell you.
Back in just a moment. Play for all of those wonderful things right after this. Thank you. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Hello, champ.
Hi.
Boy, this beats belly dancing, doesn't it?
Yes.
I know. Let me tell you, in addition to all the money you can win, we've added a couple of jokers to the deck. Every time a joker pops up, it gives you another chance of winning that little red Jeep back there, which clashes with your hair, but we can change the color of the Jeep or your hair. I'm not sure. Yeah. Anyway, just because you won the match, Susanna's got one joker for you, so you know you at least have one chance of winning that car. What we want you to do is win a lot of money, okay? Mm-hmm. Let's give her $200 to bet with, and we are on our way. All right, Katie. First card coming up. Katie happens to be a six.
Change it.
Want to change the six?
Number two.
All right. The six now is a five. And you got $200, Katie.
$150 higher.
$150 higher than the five. No. Back to $50. That's all right. We can build on it. Here we go, Katie.
All right. $50 higher.
All of it higher. Yeah.
Oh,
there we go.
Yeah.
$100.
$100 lower.
All of it lower. You bet. Nine.
Oh.
$200. Come up here, I'll give you another $400. You got $600 with the nine.
And change it with number one.
Number one.
Please.
A good card, please, Lace. Nine is, hello.
Oh, good. All of it higher.
Yeah, $1,200 worth. Look at that.
Oh, wow.
$1,200.
$1,000 lower.
$1,000 lower than the king. Jack is yours, $2,200.
Oh, $1,000 lower.
$1,000. $1,000 lower than the jack. Lady stepping out.
Nothing.
Come on, be there for her. No.
No.
It's okay. You've got $1,200. You can still turn that $1,200 into a lot of money. We're going to bring it right up here. You now have $1,200. You got to bet at least $600 of it, Katie.
All of it.
All of it.
Lower. I came with nothing. I'll go with nothing.
Well, I hope not.
Or something.
They're really rooting for you to spend your money.
Yeah, you bet.
All of it lower. Okay. If it's lower, you end up with $2,400. Then we'll go over there. We're going to give you a chance to win a brand new Jeep. We want it to be lower, okay? Lower than the king for Katie. Is it there? Yeah.
Yay!
There you go. $2,400. You already have $200. You're now at $2,600 in cash. Now, you stay right here, sweetheart, because Susanna's got a joker for you. I want you to hold on to that. I want you to take a look over here. We've got seven numbered cards. Behind one of them is the word car. If you can find it, this is the car you'll go home in. Charlie O?
The Wrangler from Jeep Corporation offers both on- and off-road driving in comfort. The Wrangler comes with Sport Decor Group and California Emission.
Okay, Katie, there you go, dear. You go find that. Why don't you turn it around, sweetheart, so it's Joker side out. There you go. Number six, the lady said. You stay right here. If number six happens to be the place where the car is, you win it, and you can drive home. Drive slow. You ready?
Yeah.
Come on, be there. Behind number six is the word. No, it was behind number four today.
Well,
there's the old car
right there. Maybe next time.
Maybe next time. If you win two more games, you're the champion. You can do it all over again.
I'll try.
She's got $2,600, though, and we will be back in just a moment with more card shows.
Oh, gee, it's exciting. I don't know whether I can live through this.
That was fast.
Sure does.
That's all the time we have. We got to go. For Susanna Williams, I'm sorry, Lacey Pemberton, Charlie O'Donnell, I'm Bob Eubanks saying thank you very much. We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
Oh, you made it.
I'm so happy.
Here, Bob. This is so great.
Come on.
Is that Mia Babbitt? I wonder if she's getting her hair done.
Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Hey.
What, you need an engraved invitation? Sit. This is your table now.
Where's Kelly?
I'm sure Kelly will grace us with her presence eventually.
Hey, I totally think that new hot guy was checking you out in the hall.
No, he wasn't. Boys never look at me.
Having the right friends does wonders for that.
Yeah, and Goddess is new, remember?
Ladies. I have some housekeeping and announcements.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that all of us are here yet.
Oh, Kelly's practicing.
Is she ever not?
It's funny, actually, how people are surprised that girls like Kelly and I work our asses off. You know, just snap our fingers and wiggle our noses.
I didn't mean...
No, of course you didn't. The first Bobette vacation is before Christmas break. We are going skiing, Lake Tahoe. I will not take no for an answer.
Oh, I love skiing. Do you need to bring anything?
Just your fabulousness and your gear. But that goes without saying.
I literally have never been skiing in my life. I wouldn't tell them that.
I don't know how I'm going to be able to afford this. I mean, I'm already babysitting twice a week.
Ask your mom?
Even if she could, she wouldn't.
Problem, Bridget?
No. Sorry, I was just saying that I'm going to have to excuse myself because my cheer routine needs practice, too.
Minx, I didn't know you were trying out for cheerleader. You and Kelly should totally practice together when we're at the chalet.
Yeah, that would be terrific.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
The all-new Card Sharks deals you a handful of excitement. Join host Bob Eubanks and watch the fun as fortunes are won with the turn of a single card. Then, he's charming, he's exciting, he's one of a kind, and he's the host of TV's hottest game show. So find out why everybody loves Bob Barker on The Price is Right and Card Sharks weekdays.
This is CBS.
The weekday morning phenomenon continues with the inquisitive Bob Eubanks.
Do you tell your wife you love her? How many of the 50?
And when contestants play their cards right,
lower back.
There's more to come.
Because the day begins with us.
Weekdays on CBS.
Weekday mornings, it's Card Sharks, and people just go crazy with fun.
Higher! Higher!
Because it's all in the cards. And the cards keep turning up winners.
Do you? Yeah! Is it there?
Yes! Card Sharks, your excitement weekdays.
This is CBS.